Hello again. So we are going to talk about the outline of this particular session. We are talking about designing, building and managing databases using SQL, PL/SQL. Actually, I have more than 15 plus years of experience teaching SQL and PL/SQL. So this outline containing which software to use, SQL or SQL, various queries or statements, data types and subcomponents of SQL. So we are going to take an idea about it. Here, the use of the software will be MySQL and or OracleTNG, because I am going to tell you about the open source software, what is MySQL, how to start with it. In addition to that, OracleTNG, and then later on I am going to take the sessions on OracleTNG, that is the proprietary software but is free to use. In MySQL, root is an admin user. In OracleTNG, system is an admin user. The meaning of the G is many groups, database management system and the application servers are connected to each other. That is, a grid is formed between them. Here, in this particular session or the tutorial or the various tutorials, we are going to work on the same machine there will be a client, and on the same machine there will be a server. But we would be in a position to connect to many machines from the server. That would be a situation which we can learn about it. So that is the idea behind it. Then there are various data types. Actually, before that, we are going to talk about what is SQL and SQL. The meaning of the SQL is structured query language, whereas SQL is another name for SQL, that is structured English query language, because it is English-like language. So whoever knows English, whoever can understand English can understand SQL very easily, and PL/SQL also will be very easy for him or her. The data types can be the number or integer. Why here I have written number or integer? The number is written in MySQL, whereas integer is written in MySQL, whereas number is written in OracleTNG. Char and varchar are both of the data types which are there in MySQL as well as OracleTNG, float and date and many more. We are going to look after them as the time comes. Please keep it in mind, in OracleTNG, whenever we are going to work, varchar 2 would be seen as varchar 2. But though we write it down varchar 2 or varchar, it would be for the characters, the alphanumeric data which we are going to enter. The meaning of it is alphabets and the numbers together. When we talk about the number or the integer, there we are going to talk about the numbers or the integers without real point values or the decimal point. And float is with respect to the decimal point values, and the date is the date which we enter as the birth date or the higher date or some other type of date, whichever we want to give. There are various statements: create database in MySQL, create table in MySQL, create tables in OracleTNG. Obviously, we can create the databases in OracleTNG, but we are going to concentrate on creating tables and how to view the data in both the softwares. And finally, we are going to talk about the subcomponents of SQL. You can see here various headings. Actually, the meaning of it is, whenever I want to show the data, display the data, it is data query language. Then we are going to create the table. I have talked to you all about the table and the database. The database is consisting of many tables together. A single table can be connected to any other table. That would be a relation. That is the RDBMS, which we have seen in the last tutorial. So when we want to create the table, whenever we want to drop the table, whenever we want to make the changes into that particular table, it can be DDL. For example, when I am talking about the order table, it has got the order number, it has got the order date, it has got the quantity. Okay, that is nothing but a table. So there are various columns and the rows. Across the rows there are records, and the columns are nothing but the vertical columns which we talk about. DML is nothing but whenever we want to insert the data. I want to say that the order number is 1, order date is today's date, and the order quantity is set 10. So that is a record. So that record can be entered by using DML. Then we can save the data in such a way that by using commit, if I want to go back, if I don't want to store the data, I want to go back for the various for the last record whatever I had stored. Okay, that is a rollback. It can be save point. We are going to talk about it. And finally, we are going to talk about the DCL, that is the data control language, which allows us to create the various users, drop the users, changing the passwords, etc. So that was all about today's session. That was just the beginning. And in the next session, in the next tutorial, we are going to talk about the how to make use of MySQL or Oracle 10G. Stay tuned. Thank you very much.